The 12 Months, written by Philip Craddock, illustrated by June Julie. Once there was a young girl named Mara, who lived with her stepmother, Farah, and her stepsister, Helen. Farah hated Mara, for she was far prettier than Helen. Mara couldn't understand why her stepmother disliked her. She gave all the hardest chores to Mara. Meanwhile, Helen relaxed. Even though life was hard, Mara never complained. Over time, Mara's beauty increased, and Helen became uglier.
"We have to get rid of Mara,"
Farah whispered to Helen. One day, Helen went to Mara with a seemingly impossible task.
"Sister, climb the mountain and find me violets. They must be fresh and sweet-scented."
"But it's winter,"
Mara replied.
"Don't disobey me,"
Helen snapped.
"Bring violets or be punished."
Farah pushed Mara outside. Mara hiked through thick snow until she became lost. Then she saw a light in the distance. Mara followed the light to the top of the mountain. There she saw 12 strange beings sitting around a fire on 12 blocks of stone. They were the 12 months.
"Excuse me,"
Mara said. January turned and spoke to her.
"What brings you here?"
"I'm looking for violets,"
Mara replied.
"This isn't the season for violets,"
January answered.
"My sister ordered me to bring violets from your mountain. If I return without them, I'll be punished,"
Mara explained. January turned to another month, gave him his wand, and said,
"March, assist her."
March waved the wand over the fire. Flames rose to the sky. Snow melted, and the grass became green. It was spring, and the meadows were covered with violets.
"Gather quickly, Mara,"
said March. Mara picked the flowers, then hurried home. Helen was astonished.
"Where did you find them?"
asked Helen.
"On the mountain,"
said Mara. The next day, Helen had another task.
"Fetch strawberries from the mountain,"
Helen said,
"or you'll be punished."
Before she could argue, Farah pushed Mara outside. Mara climbed the mountain and met the 12 months.
"What do you seek?"
January asked.
"I'm looking for strawberries,"
she replied.
"This isn't the season for strawberries,"
January said.
"I know,"
Mara sadly replied.
"But if I don't return with strawberries, I'll be punished."
January gave June his wand and said,
"June, help her."
June obeyed, waving the wand over the fire. Flames leaped to the sky. Snow melted, and it became summer. Strawberries grew next to Mara's feet.
"Gather quickly, Mara,"
said June. Mara thanked the months, gathered strawberries, and hurried home to Helen.
"Where did you find them?"
asked Helen crossly.
"In the mountains,"
answered Mara. The next day, it was apples that Helen requested, and September who came to Mara's aid. Yet he only gave her 2 apples to return with.
"Where did you gather them?"
asked Helen.
"There's more on the mountaintop,"
answered Mara.
"Then why bring only 2?
Helen shouted.
"Mother,"
said Helen,
"we'll fetch more apples."
Helen and Farah climbed to the top of the mountain, where they met the 12 months. Helen warmed her hands by their fire. She didn't ask permission, nor speak politely.
What do you seek?
January asked.
I don't have to tell you,
Helen yelled.
That's right,
Farah angrily agreed. January frowned and waved his wand. The fire went out and snow fell in large flakes. Helen and Farah became hopelessly lost in the snow and never found their way home. The next morning, Mara was awoken by a familiar voice whispering in her ear. It was January.
The house and all the land surrounding it is yours now, Mara. You were kind and polite to your elders and sought no reward. And yet now you have it.
But what of my stepmother and stepsister?
Mara asked. January smiled at her.
They are safe, but somewhere where they will never hurt you again,
January explained. Mara soon settled into her new life and lived happily ever after.